The Minnesota environmental review process requires that certain proposed projects that could impact Minnesota's environment go through a review process before getting any required permits or approvals. The Environmental Assessment Worksheet, or EAW, is the most commonly completed Minnesota environmental review document. The EAW describes the proposed project, details its potential environmental effects, and identifies ways to reduce negative impacts to the environment. The development of the Environmental Assessment Worksheet is not an approval process. It provides information about the project to the project proposer and members of the public. It also helps state agencies, cities, counties, and other governmental units make better informed decisions when issuing permits or approvals. So, if a project requires an EAW, who carries out the environmental review process? That responsibility usually falls to the governmental unit with the most oversight over the project, known as the Responsible Governmental Unit, or RGU. Examples of RGUs can include state agencies, cities, counties, or soil and water conservation districts. Once it's determined that an EAW must be prepared for a project, no permits or approvals can be issued for the project until the EAW process is completed. The process is explained in more detail in Minnesota law, but can be simplified into four major steps. The project proposer fills out the Environmental Assessment Worksheet. The EAW is a form that includes a series of questions related to the environmental impacts of the project on air, land, and water resources. The project proposer then submits the EAW to the Responsible Governmental Unit. The RGU reviews and supplements the EAW as needed to ensure that it is complete and accurate. Once the RGU determines that the Environmental Assessment Worksheet is complete, it is sent to other governmental units for review and is made available to the public. Notice of the EAW is published in the EQB Monitor, which starts a 30-day public comment period. Once the comment period ends, the RGU develops a record of decision, which includes specific findings from the EAW and written responses to comments. The record of decision, along with criteria in Minnesota law, helps the RGU's board, council, or other governing body determine if additional environmental review is needed through the preparation of an Environmental Impact Statement, or EIS. Finally, if an Environmental Impact Statement is required for the project, the EIS process must be completed before the project can move forward. If an EIS is not needed, then the project can move forward with the required permits and approvals. Either way, the RGU must post a notice of their decision in the EQB Monitor. The EQB website has a number of guidance documents that provide more detailed information on completing the Environmental Assessment Worksheet process. If you have additional questions, you can also contact EQB staff directly by phone or email using the contact information provided.